Housing Stamp. We have a meeting on the panel on the 9th of October. We will get an update from the members' team on that. I think we look forward to seeing what improvements can be made and gradually address the concerns that members are raising about the whole situation at the time. Thank you, members. Now moving on to item 7, which is the quarter one performance. And we do have two officers who are going to talk to us in detail about aspects. One of our board is going to talk about safe wheel stairs, and Jason obviously is going to talk about health and care outcomes and their wage disability service. I wonder if I'm going to take Mark first, because you've sat through our business very patiently and have many other duties. We're well aware of the pressures that you have on the various services that you have to manage. So this is going to be fair to bring you first on this matter. About domestic abuse. This is something that many committee members have been following, and some concerns about the figures and what they actually mean. And also, if I remember rightly, there is some legislation that was in the Commons or is somewhere in the Commons, but has yet to make any progress. It might provide a new national framework. But our concerns have been understanding how the police interpret data and how our teams at the centre that receives concerns also interpret the data. And I hope that your presentation will give us a picture of where things are now, as we are expecting a more detailed report with some suggestions for changing the service to come before us at our next meeting, I think. So, Mark, do explain things, and if you've got a presentation on the highway, I'm going to move so I can watch it as well. Thank you very much.
I've got a presentation, I'm not sure. Alex, have we got a clicker? I don't need to do it from there.
Just not.
I do a lot of nodding.
I've been providing the screen so I can now see it as well.
Okay,
so there's a technology. Thank you very much.
So Chair, thank you very much for inviting me to the committee. First of all, I want to start off with an apology. My apology is that I haven't had a report, which is what I wanted to do to this committee. But I wanted to explain the reason why I haven't got a report. One is that we are coming to the end of our pledge, our five-year pledge, and the intention is to hold a all-inclusive workshop sometime before Christmas, so that we can get all parties and everybody who's engaged across the Wirral landscape involved in tackling, dealing, or supporting domestic abuse and harmful practices, so that we can move towards a far more co-produced model in terms of what that abuse strategy looks like moving on from 2020 onwards. I did speak with the chair of the Children's Committee and also with domestic abuse champion Councillor Nolan about the timing of this, but I absolutely accept the fact that there's been a call out for more detail around the data around domestic abuse and to understand the work we've been doing and where what impact that's been having. So that's my apology. The other apology I have, unfortunately, is I was hoping to be accompanied by one of our police colleagues today from the investigatory side of the police force. But unfortunately, she was unable to attend tonight. However, the slides I'm going to go through, I discussed with her, she's happy for me to talk through those. But if some of the questions are about matters which I can't answer, I'll happily take those away and ask for a response back by either email or written by the police themselves. So, in terms of the first part of the presentation, these all deal with police data, which is open source data, and deals with how Merseyside police have moved towards recording domestic abuse and statistics around domestic abuse. And the first part, slide there talks about the dispatch rate. So this is all about call-out times from the phone call made into Merseyside Police and how quickly they either prioritise or respond to a domestic abuse incident that's in place. And these are four figures. So in terms of the top line there, which is about emergency, this is a 10-minute, the force set themselves a target a 10-minute from the call taken at the control room to our officer attending this incident. This target has remained above 97% for over 12 months, which nationally across the piece is a very, very strong position to be in. There's a lot of forces that aren't at that level. I'd also like to say, in addition to that, what we've done as well in terms of the other agencies, we've moved more recently over the last 6 months or so, we've put an IVA, an independent domestic violence advocate from our family support unit, working in and out of Birkenhead Police Station, accompanying the duty detective that's on there, so that when these calls come in, they're at a higher rating. We've got an IVA there in the science hours of Friday, Saturday and Sunday, which can respond as part of that. Again, nobody else is doing that across Merseyside, and I'm unsure that anyone's doing that across nationally at the moment. But again, the indications back from that are a very strong position to be in. In terms of the priority calls, this is when a triage has taken place without mission call come in, and priority calls target the Merseyside police will attend 1 hour from then when that call is taken at the control room to the police officer attending the incident. So in essence, the top line is about when there is considered to be a high risk of injury or violence taking place. The lower line is less of a risk, but still the police want to have a target there to attend. And on that one, you can see that it's sort of peaks and troughs, but at the moment it's operating at 77%. In terms of the domestic abuse incident numbers, you can see again there's a whole journey of up and down, peaks and troughs as this goes through. Some of those can be explained by sort of seasonal approach to this that we understand from our data across a whole number of years that at certain times there is increased risk of domestic abuse incidents. And if you look at that first line, 617, summer period when kids break up from school and things of that nature, that often can lead to an increase in domestic violence, as it can when we get into the Christmas period as well. But these are the numbers that are reported to the police and not necessarily the number that which are investigated. And if more than one offence takes place, i.e. a section that's 39 assault and criminal damage, only one is recorded as an incident, and in effect the police call out and the previous slide alludes to that. The figures, therefore, in this slide don't necessarily reflect the number of actual incidents. The increase in incidents, however, is affected, or could have been affected, by third-party reports of crime for partner agencies and members of the public, i.e. strategy meetings, MARAC, and from the NSPCC. And it could be argued, this is police comments, not my comments, but it could be argued that confidence has improved with the police response, which has also increased reporting. And I think one of the points I want to make around this pledge is